person again?
Okay.
We're gathered today in the presence of God, our families, and friends to celebrate one of life's most sacred moments. We gather to affirm the worth and beauty of love and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words that will unite Camille Lunde and Robert Higgs in holy matrimony. As we begin, I invite you to share a moment of silence. Let us remember and give thanks for the angels who watch over us in this transforming moment. Sometimes the way forward begins with a look backward. How did these two reach this great day? How did they decide to share life together? Robert and Camille met on Hinge, a dating website, in September 2019. They became engaged in December 2022. They met when Robert was stationed in San Antonio, Texas, and Camille was working as an emergency room nurse. No, he was not her patient.
It's valid.
Their first date lasted 7 hours. This is unscientific, but I've kind of discovered that folks with reasonably long first dates have a chance of building a lasting relationship. Shortly after they began dating, the government gave Robert an all-expense-paid trip to Pensacola, Florida. Yeah. Went down there for some significant training, and while he was there, Camille flew out to see him as often as she could work it out. From 2020 to 2022, Robert was sent on multiple deployments to exotic ports of call. A theme of their relationship became long distance. In 2022, Camille began nurse practitioner school just as the couple was moving to Pensacola for more training. In 2023, they traded the Florida beaches for winter snow with their move to Columbia, Maryland. Robert and Camille were in perpetual motion, it seemed, but one of the center points of their lives was Zeus, their furby. Another sign of hope for their marriage. Both of them have grandparents whose marriages have lasted over 50 years and 60 years for one couple. They've chosen a couple of Bible passages to share with us that characterize the nature of the relationship they're building. From 1 Corinthians 13, love is very patient and kind, never jealous or envious, never boastful or proud. Love does not demand its own way. Love is not irritable or touchy. Love does not hold grudges and will hardly notice when others do it wrong. Love is never glad about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. If you love someone, you will be loyal to them no matter the cost. You will always believe in them, always expect the best in them, and always stand your ground defending them. Robert and Camille have vows that they will say to each other now to describe their hopes for.
Let's I'll go first.
Michael.
Nah, just.
Nah,
it's like 50-50.
Yeah, we can talk into this. I'm pretty loud, but they'll figure it out. Camille, you're the most incredible woman I know. Your compassion, love, and patience is inspiring. What truly amazes me is how you manage your crazy schedule that you've maintained the 5 years we know each other. Without ever making Zeus or I feel as if we are taking a back seat to work or school. You have an incredible capacity for love and support that makes us feel cherished every single day. I look forward to continuing our culinary adventures. They started out with me learning that people eat beets that come from cans, and you learning that people eat beets that don't come from cans. I know that I could be a handful, yet from the moment we met almost 5 years ago, you haven't just become my wife now, you've become my best friend over that time. You've embraced me and my crazy family from the very start. I feel lucky to have found someone who can not only put up with me, but is seamlessly integrated into my family. I cannot wait to see what life has in store for us, as long as it doesn't involve us living in Florida again. Standing here today in front of our friends and family in my hometown, marrying my best friend really is a dream come true. I love you, and I'm sorry the dog likes me more.
Take it back. I want to take this back. Yeah. Turn it off.
Too late.
Jesus.
Robert, it's been almost 5 years since we had our first date. Our first date that lasted almost 7 hours because we just talked and talked like old friends catching up. There were no awkward pauses or feelings of nervousness that normally accompany a first date. Only one awkward kiss at the end of the night where I probably misread what was intended to be a hug. We just seemed to fit. Flash forward a few dates and you were given orders to go to a school in Pensacola, Florida. I thought our late summer fling was probably over at this point, but to my surprise, you asked me to come visit you. Whether your offer was wholehearted or just to be nice, I took it. And to my family and friends' surprise, I got on a plane to spend time with what they felt was a complete stranger, as we had only known each other for a few weeks. I can still remember my grandma's apprehension on what I was to do if you didn't show up at the airport to pick me up. Well, thank goodness you did, although I never doubted you. We had so much fun, and you went through a lot of effort to make that week so special. A few months later, we were in Phoenix, Arizona for Christmas. This was the first time you met my family and the first time I met your parents. We all got along together so well. I never told you at the time because you probably would have ran away, but I knew that Christmas you were my person and you were going to be my husband. Since then, we have been through a lot, whether that has been getting through multiple deployments, finding out how to integrate back together after deployments, moving twice, in peace school, your courses for work, or just whatever life seems to throw at us, which seems like a lot at times. But we've gotten through it all, and we've made it this far together. When I look to our future, I am so excited. I cannot wait for all the places we will travel, all the things we will accomplish, all the things we will celebrate, and the children we will raise, and the life we will create together. I cannot wait for all the good things to come as I have you to enjoy them with. I am not naive though, and I do realize that life is not perfect or always full of great things. We have already gotten through hard things together, but life will inevitably bring us more challenges. I'm so fortunate to have you by my side to go through whatever challenges we may face because with you, I am stronger. I am very excited for our future, but I am extremely fulfilled with our current stage in life, which includes daily walks on our trail with Zeus and our nightly couch snuggles with the three of us binging the latest show we're obsessed with. Robert, I am so honored to call you my husband. You have the biggest heart, although you don't let many people see that side of you. You are the calm to whatever I have going on in work, life, or school. You are caring, supportive, funny, and most importantly, you're my best friend. I cannot say enough good things about you, but to keep it brief to avoid anyone having a heat stroke out here, I simply cannot imagine spending my life without you.
I'd like you to join hands now. And these are the vows that most of us have taken as we have entered into marriage together. Robert, repeat after me. Robert. I'm sorry. You don't have to repeat.
Okay.
I will just ask you a question. Robert, will you have Camille to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Camille, will you have Robert to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
May I have the rings? Slip that on her finger and repeat after me. This ring is a symbol.
This ring is a symbol.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Love.
Love.
And devotion to you.
And devotion to you.
I will always love you.
I will always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
And honor the vows spoken here today.
And honor the vows spoken here today.
This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love. Seemed aggressive.
This
not
ring,
going anywhere.
This ring is a symbol.
This ring is a symbol.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Love and devotion to you.
Love and devotion to you.
I will always love you.
I will always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
And honor the vows spoken here today.
And honor the vows spoken here today.
This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
Now that Camille and Robert have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen.
Amen.
Now may the Lord smile upon you in all your comings and goings. May every new day be another chance to grow as one in wisdom, trust, and love. May you always share more blessings and burdens, more laughter than tears, and more strength for what lies ahead than you will ever need. May your hearts not forget that love lasts when you put faith and family first. Many happy years from now, may you still be walking hand in hand under God's heaven. Now turn and face the congregation. Friends, I present to you Robert and Camille Higgs.
So fuck about first dance.
Put your hands together, make some noise for your newlyweds, the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Higgs.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Something in your eyes was so inviting, something in your smile was so exciting, something in my heart told me I must have you. the night, up to the moment when we said our first hello. Little did we know, love was just a glance away, a warm embracing dance away. And ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight. In love forever, it turned out so right, for strangers in the night. Just a glance away, a warm embracing dance away. Ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight. In love forever, it turned out so right, for strangers in the night. Do-dee-doo-be-doo.
Okay, Robert, just remember, no take backs. I just want to say congratulations to Camille and Robert. I'm extremely excited for both of you. You both have incredibly bright futures ahead of you. Robert, she loves a challenge. Everything you can do, she will say, I can do that. And she will try it. So on that note, just remember to always challenge each other and then always support each other through those challenges. Congratulations. Thank you. Love y'all. Thank you.
So if you didn't hear me last night, you missed a really, really good speech. It was next level. And you should probably ask Robert and Camille why you were not invited. That's a whole nother thing. So Paula is gonna carry the mantle tonight for the Higgs.
Okay, I suck at public speaking. Okay, I love you guys. And I think the first time we met you, I just knew. And then you ruined my Boston trip. That's all I want to say about that. I feel like I can finally post my pictures from Boston and Salem. Very happy about that. Anyway, I am just stunned and amazed and just, I cannot believe. Just watching you grow up and just who you become, I mean, you've surpassed us so many years ago. I mean, I just don't even know how that happened. I think we grew up together because I had you when I was 23 years old. And I just, Camille, for you to put up with him is just amazing. And I am just excited to see what's next, and I just hope that I can be a part of that. And he's yours.
Okay, that's enough now. Okay. We're good. Look, I already had my wedding. Thank you, I appreciate it. Okay, no more cheers for me. Okay. This is about Robert, mostly Camille. Okay, thank you. So I am Michael Higgs, if anyone doesn't know that. I am Robert's younger brother. I'm also the better looking one.
Come on. No, come on. There we go. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, most of the speech is about me. Anyway, so throughout our childhood and into our adult lives, we have always been close, from family trips to Beaver, Utah, to Courtney and I traveling to wherever Camille and Robert put their new homestead. Not Florida. I heard about that. That was bad. Every once in a while,
me and Robert's childhood, we would find trouble, or Robert would bring the trouble home, and I would end up in handcuffs. If you want to hear about that story, $5. Sorry. But beyond all the crazy nights, I've always looked up to Robert as more than just a sibling, but as a true role model. His dedication and determination he has put in his career, his past baseball life, thank God it's over, family, especially Zeus, and even golf, which I know a lot of us will agree on this, is subpar. But it's all pushed me to be a better person. I've always tried to be at least half the man Robert is. Camille, I know he might not show it on his face, but every time I see him with you, he's the happiest I've ever seen him, and we've been through a lot of stuff. Camille, you have brought a side of Robert that I've never thought I would see in my entire life, so thank you. Mostly, it's being a dog dad to Zeus, which has made him a giant softy. You guys are amazing, and you and are going to be unforgettable, or sorry. You guys are amazing and are going to have an unforgettable journey through this next chapter. I'm so thrilled to have another older sister and someone who cares for Robert like I do and our family. Lastly, I know Robert can be a handful, Camille. So just to let you know, good luck. And he's your problem now. So let's raise a glass to Robert and Camille.
Everybody, my name is Cassandra, and I'm Camille's maid of honor. For starters, I would just like to thank everyone for being here, for traveling near and far, for these two lovebirds on this special day. I just wanted to give a little bit of background. So I met Camille back in, like, I think 2018. It was at our first job, our first nursing job, and I never thought I would really be standing up here today. I'm sorry, I can't even look at you. Okay, I'm incredibly honored to be here today, and I can't believe how far, like, our friendship has gone. You have made, like, such a big impact on my life. She has, like, a heart of gold. And she is, like, such a special person. And I hope you guys are both happy and have a lovely life together. Okay, without further ado, if anyone would raise a glass to the bride and groom, may your love grow stronger with each passing day. Cheers.